Here's a picture that we found on the internet that was really important to us. It's a drawing that William Holmes did in 1882, the panorama from Point Sublime. This was really, I think, an icon of the Grand Canyon. It's really stood as one of the classic drawings of the canyon, and it's still thought of as one of the most accurate drawings of the Grand Canyon. We downloaded this picture and realized that it's actually one of three images made of the canyon that go together. And you can see here that the three of them form a continuous panorama from that view of Point Sublime. So we took it out to the site.
And one of the most amazing things about the panorama itself is how you can stand at the point at Point Sublime and look at the space and look at the panorama that we had with us and just sort of marvel at the accuracy and how the feeling of the Holmes piece seemed to really represent what the actual place felt like. And we were really sort of challenged with how we could go about making any new pictures that responded to or sort of got into a conversation with the original Holmes. So we really just set about making a lot of photographs, hoping we could figure out what we would have ultimately do.
So we made about 1,000 pictures, and we didn't know what to do with it. This is a case where we didn't have a clear idea when we were in the field. So we brought them home. We studied the Holmes drawing more closely, and then we started corresponding through email, through sending files back and forth, and started looking more carefully at our pictures. So one of the things we found was that instead of trying to recreate the Holmes drawing, maybe we could actually take our photographs and find a way that they fit with inside the Holmes drawing.
And so one of the things we did was try to identify little details that we thought were important from the space. Sometimes they were details that were fixed, like the Colorado River here. Sometimes they were details that were more transient, like light raking across the canyon itself. And so we tried to be, the choices we tried to make reflected things that were a little bit more transient than some of the things that we often saw.
Really, the experience that we had when we were there, we spent over 2 days there, and there you see a storm over the south rim. You see a sunset. You see sunrises, like here, a raven flying overhead. And so one of the things that Holmes could do was draw the picture very, very accurately. But the picture is almost timeless. And what we decided to do was populate the image with the timely experiences that we had that really reflected the moments of the kind of experience that we had.